And I just felt led to pray from Psalm 119, the same thing that the priest prays. I would say, Lord, would you turn this student's eyes from worthless things? Because at that year, Penn State was, you know, chosen as the number one party school in the nation. There's a lot of, you can imagine, college life. And 2 months later, I got a Facebook message from a parent. And by the way, it's always bad news if you get a message from a parent. College professors never want to hear from parents. But in this case, the parent said, our son gave us permission. He was in your class. We're coming to town. We really want to take you out to lunch. I said, okay. I go to lunch, and this couple says, you don't understand. We almost lost our son. He got to Penn State. You know, we tried to raise him in a good home, but he just was drinking and partying and doesn't care about God at all. And all of a sudden, he starts talking about that he has a Christian professor who goes to church, who doesn't get drunk on the weekends. By the way, I taught him many things. That's the only thing he remembered. And the mom starts crying, and she said, we just kept praying. We just kept praying that God would send someone to turn him back, to turn his eyes back. And I told her, I said, well, you're not going to believe this. I prayed Psalm 119 over your son, that God would turn his eyes from worthless things. So she started crying, and she was like, where does it say that in the Bible? You know, and then the dad, this was the best part for me. The dad, who's this big guy, he looked like he could crush me, you know, covered in tattoos, you know, a bodybuilder. I was like, this is the end for me. No, he turns to me and he said, if ever you think that what you're doing is not worth it, I want you to remember my son. We were so worried about him, and God sent you.